Yo, what is up guys? My name is AFC Dino, and today we are going to play the team that we made in the previous team building video. If you haven't checked out that video yet, I will put a link down in the description. It's basically, we were basically building a team around Choice, Bandit, Garchomp. So definitely check it out. I will be playing the team now in a few games. So I hope you guys enjoy the video. Let's go right into it. Okay, we got a game against Gunners. Let's just lead with Fortress and try to get up to Stealthrox early. That's usually what you want to do with Fortress. And even if he leads up with Magnezone, we have the Shed Shell so we can switch out. But having those Stealthrox is really important as it pressures the Heracross, Muk, Mamoswine and the Dragonite. And obviously it also pressures the Starmie to Rapid Spin. So Stealthrox are going to be really important as he does lead up with Magnezone. But that's fine, we can bring in our Garchomp, and if he goes for Hidden Power Fire, we can get off a big hit, guys. So we do, he does go for Hidden Power Fire, and I am going to go for the Dragon Claw, because anything will get 2-hit KO'd. Because I could go for Outrage and kill something, but then he can either bring in his Mamoswine or his Starmie and Revenge kill me, and that's not what I want. I want to reserve my Garchomp so that he can never spam electric attacks with his Magnezone. So he does bring in his Mamoswine. Now I get to bring in my Fortress. If he goes for Stealthrox, I can just Rapid Spin them away. And if he goes for Earthquake, I can go for my own Stealthrox. So we go for Rapid Spin here, and yeah, let's see what he does. He brings in his Heracross, so I get some free chip damage off on his Heracross, which is nice. Because after the next turn, he will be in range of Fire Fang. But yeah, I'm going to use Stealthrox now, as he goes for Close Combat, so he doesn't go for Sword Dance, which is great. Because now I'll be able to bring in my Zapdos. Facade should not knock me out. And my Zapdos is faster than this Heracross. I can knock it out afterwards. So let's see if he stays in. I'm going for Heat Wave. He does stay in, so he was most likely going for Facade. And Heracross goes down, so that is really great for us, guys. This big threat is gone. I don't have to switch into Heracross anymore. But yeah, let's see what he brings in now. If he does bring in his Mamoswine, we will go into Fortress. If he goes Starmie, then he has to go for Ice Beam to knock me out. Which means I can bring in my Muk. Yeah, I do want to keep my Zapdos alive. In case his Dragonite is Choice Bandit, perhaps. And he has Earthquake, and it's also nice for the Mamoswine. This Mamoswine can only knock me out with Ice Shard. He goes for Ice Beam, and now I'm going for Pursuit. And yeah, he goes for Rapid Spin, but that Rapid Spin did cost him his Pokemon. So Muk doing his job. He doesn't go down, but it's still fine. I only need my Muk in this game for the Starmie anyway. So Starmie will die to his own Life Orb. And Muk putting in the work. Because now now I won't have any pressure from the Starmie as well. As he brings in his Mamoswine. He should be really going for Earthquake here. So, but I'm still going to bring in my Fortress. And he goes for Earthquake, but he takes Life Orb damage. And now he has room for one more attack. I will be going for Stealthrox here in case he goes for his own Stealthrox. As it does pressure his Dragonite, as he goes for Ice Shard. So now this Mamoswine only has room for two more attacks. So therefore I'm going into Starmie here. Because I still have my Clefable at full HP. And Mamoswine can only do two more attacks. I'm going for Surf, he will bring in his Muk. But I at least will get damage off on this Muk. And this Muk will basically be in range of Earthquake. Of Dragon Claw from my Garchomp, which is what I needed. I'm just gonna surf again. Don't need to Starmie anymore. He goes for knockoff, and now I'm going to bring in my Garchomp. And I'm just gonna press Earthquake. I do not care about the Dragonite because I do have my Clefable. So we're just gonna press Earthquake. Yeah, we do really not. Wait, in hindsight, I should have gone for Fire Fang because Fire Fang would have killed this Muk. And it also would have done damage on the Mamoswine. It would have killed the Mamoswine. It would have done damage on the Magnezone, and it also would have broken the multi-skill from Dragonite. So in the future, use Fire Fang in this kind of situation. But yeah, we are going to bring in our Clefable now. He might go for Rocks, which means our Clefable will be at full HP. If he goes for Earthquake, he will take Life Orb damage. Then I can Sekhmuk. As long as I keep my Clefable at around half HP, it's fine. Then it can still check the Dragonite. So he does go for Stealth Rocks, which means Clefable is at full HP. And I'm just gonna go for the Wish here, because I think he will switch out. Actually goes for Earthquake. But now I'm just gonna go for the Protect. And this Mamoswine has only room for one more attack. After his attack, he will die to Life Orb. And my Clefable will basically be at full HP here. Now, because he switched, I can protect again. I can double protect because my previous protect failed, which means my next protect won't fail. And I get to see what this Magnezone will do. Goes for Flash Cannon, so if he's scarfed, then he cannot two-hit KO my Zapdos. If he specs, my Zapdos will be faster, which means I can roost before his next Flash Cannon connects. Let's see. He does go for Flash Cannon and he appears to be Choice Scarfed. So his next Flash Cannon won't knock me out. I get off the roost. He brings in his Mamoswine and I can pretty much press Hidden Power Ice here because Ice Shard is not knocking me out from this amount of health. So he doesn't go for Ice Shard and my Zapdos is very healthy right now. I can hit the Dragonite with Hidden Power Ice if I want. But honestly, if he does go Dragonite, then I can just go into my Clefable. Because he cannot touch my Clefable. Yeah, the question is if this Dragonite is Bandit or Dragon Dance. Let's see, he goes for Dragon Claw. Dragon Claw, so he might be Dragon Dance. Yeah, I'm just gonna go for the Wish here. As he does switch into his Magnezone. And this is why I love the combination with Muk and Clefable. Because my Muk still has the Assault Vest, so his Magnezone cannot knock me out. I have the Wish up, so I can regenerate my Muk with the Wish here. Wish passing to Muk. Goes for Flash Cannon, I easily live that. And Muk is healthy again, and I can pretty much press knockoff. Because if he switches, then I get some nice damage on his Dragonite. And if he stays in, I get rid of Magnezone's knockoff and put him in range of Choice Bandit Outrage from my Garchomp. So he stays in, that's fine. Here I'm gonna go for the Fire Punch to knock out the Magnezone or to get damage off on the Dragonite, breaking his multi skill if he goes for Volt Switch like he does now. And I think we have won the game right now because we Fire Punched this guy. Multi skill has been broken and he shows Lumberry, so he's not even Choice Bandit, which means he cannot do anything against my Clefable, who is at full HP. But he decides to forfeit, and that's basically the first game. So I see you guys in the next game. Okay, we got a game against Beetlejuice. He's playing a rain team. I'm just gonna lead up with Zapdos. Zapdos usually can do a lot against rain teams. And he will most likely lead off with Politoed anyway. He does lead off with Politoed. I'm just gonna press Thunderbolt, even though I know he has a Gliscor. I still have Hidden Power Ice. I don't know if he knows that I have hidden power eyes, but it's fine. He does go into Gliscor, which is the only thing on his team that can switch into an electric attack. I'm going for hidden power eyes now. And this should do a lot of damage to him. Definitely be a 2-hit KO. He does switch out into his Kingdra, so pretty decent play on his part. But yeah, I'm just gonna stay in here. I really don't have anything that can revenge kill this too. Yeah, Ice Beam should not knock me out if he does go for it, and perhaps he doesn't have the balls to press Hydro Pump. Because if he does kill me, then I can go into Starmie and go for Psyshock. He does go for Ice Beam, so this should not knock me out, as he does get the freeze, and this is really unfortunate. Because I would have gotten off my T-Bolt damage. And he also appeared to be Life Orbed. He would have been really low, and then I could have pursuit trapped him with Mug. Fuck. And then Kingdra would have been gone, and that wasn't just Rain Sweeper. Because with Kingdra gone, he wouldn't have anything to sweep me, because I'm not afraid of Toxicroak. But yeah, I'm going for knockoff as he brings in his Skarmory. I'm going to bring in my Fortress here. Perhaps I should have gone for pursuit, to be honest. Because the rain would have ended after that turn, so perhaps I should have gone for pursuit. But yeah, I'm going for rapid spin here as he brings in his Politoed. I get rid of the rapid spin and I will set up my stealth rocks here. I have the sturdy, and Skull should definitely not knock me out as he goes for Hydro Pump. Okay. Just gonna stay in here, I think. Let's just go for Pain Split if he attacks me again, as he does attack me again. Perhaps I should have actually gone for Explosion. Because it was Hydro Pump, so... Oh my god, I'm making so many bad plays here. If I go Starmie, then I can take the hit, kill it, perhaps. Yeah, that's free. Oh, what am I doing? It's Hydro Pump, guys. He could be Choice Scarfed, so he might 2-hit KO me. Fuck. Yeah, now I might as well stay in. And pursuit trap him with Mug. And then at least he won't have the rain anymore. Yeah, the downside now is that killing Skarmory is almost impossible for me. Yeah, I still have Fire Fang on my Garchomp, and his rain setter is gone. Yeah, he goes into Skarmory. Takes the rocks damage. He's gonna Fire Punch here as he goes for Brave Bird. Into Fortress. At least remove his entry hazards as he goes for Roost. Gonna Pain Split here if he goes for Roost again as he switches out. So at least now he cannot switch into Fire Fang. So if I can knock him out with Fire Fang, that would be nice. Here I will go into my Clefable. Since Clefable can set up on Zapdos as he appears to be Rain Dance. Oh, this is really bad, guys. This is really bad. Holy shit. So now I cannot 2-hit KO Skarmory with Fire Fang. because the Fire Fang damage is reduced by the rain. I will go into Fortress here. Because I don't think he should Swords Dance now, because I have a Calm Mind up. So he should definitely go for Poison Jab or something as he goes for a Gunk Shot. I'm just gonna go for Explosion here. I have the Stealth Rocks up. His spikes are removed. And I get a lot of damage off here. As he goes for Swords Dance himself, that's fine. And now I go into Garchomp. And Skarmory is most likely gonna come in here. But I basically have to hope that I can, that I get a crit. Get one crit on Skarmory. That's the only way I can now knock him out, because of the rain dance from Zapdos. Honestly, I could have gone for Fire Fang. Because the rain would have stopped after this turn, and then I would have been able to knock him out with Fire Fang. We do get a crit. We actually got two crits, so I'm really playing bad right now. But at this point, Garchomp is gonna take over the game because we took care of the Skarmory. But honestly, I should have gone for Fire Fang there, because the next Fire Fang would have done about 40%. So he goes for Rain Dance again, but what I can do now is I can just stall the rain turns with Clefable. His Zapdos cannot knock me out. Let's just go for Calm Mind here. As he goes for Thunder, he doesn't paralyze me, which is great. I get up a Calm Mind. I'm just gonna go for the Wish here, in case he does double. But yeah, this is nice, because now I can protect. He tried to go for U-turn there. And now I can just... I'll just go for Moonblast here. As he goes for Thunder. Still doesn't get the paralysis. And I get a nice amount of damage. This might force him to Roost. I do not want to knock him out though, because if he does go for Rain Dance, then he gets a free switch into his Kingdra, which I will not allow him to bring in his Kingdra in the rain, basically. So I'm just gonna stall the rain turns again. And at this point, I don't think this guy has Roost. He showed Thunder, he showed U-turn, and he showed Rain Dance. He does paralyze me now, but that's okay. What I'm gonna do now is I'm going to go into my Garchomp, because I don't think he will go into Kingdra on a potential Moonblast. There's either second Toxicroak, or he goes for Thunder again. So I get the nice side of the 50-50, and I can go for Outrage here. Gliscor will get 2-hit KO'd if he does bring in the Gliscor, and this is why Choice Banded Garchomp is so insane. Look at this, 73%. So he sacks his Gliscor, which is nice. And he still has to take a... Outrage is still up. So he decides to go into Zapdos, but honestly, he should have just went into his Toxicroak, let that thing die, and set up the Rain Dance with Zapdos afterwards, after my confusion. And then he should have tried to sweep with Clefable. But that's the game. I made a lot of mistakes in that game, but we still managed to pull it off. And let's see if we can find another game. Okay. We got a game against Stablecoon. He brings a Choice Pack Explode most likely. So definitely a lot of fire on this guy's team. But again, I'll just lead off with my Fortress. Try to get up the Stealth Rocks. Like in most games. Just the Sturdy will always ensure that I get up my rocks. He leads off with Garchomp. Fire Blast could definitely be coming. But I really want those rocks up, to be honest. Could be bringing in my Zapdos, actually. Let's bring in Zapdos, because I need my Fortress for the Memo Swine, just in case. As he appears to have Fire Fang and he's Life Orbed. I'm just gonna press Hidden Power Ice as he goes for Stealth Rocks. But yeah, this guy is Life Orbed, so... He will still live another hit. I'm just gonna go for the roost here. As Mammoth Swine does come in, so this is great. Because I can actually get up my Rapid Spin now. I can bring in my Fortress now. Get my Zapdos at full HP. And basically, got 3 damage on his Garchomp as he goes for Icicle Crash, which does nothing. We don't see a Life Orb on this guy, so what I'm actually gonna do is I'm gonna Earthquake. Stealth Rocks. As he goes for Earthquake. And I'm just gonna Pain Split now. Because for Icicle Crash, was perhaps predicting me to switch, and unfortunately, he flinches me. So, that is really annoying. I'm just gonna stay in and let my Fortress die then. Because now I can bring in my Starmie. And tell me what is going to switch in on a Choice Pack Surf, guys. The real surprise would be if this Mammoth Swine is actually Focus Sash. Okay, he stays in. We knock out the Mammoth Swine. Unfortunately, we weren't able to remove the Stealth Rocks, but we still got our own Stealth Rocks up, which pressures his Zapdos and his Arcanine. And if he wants to remove the Stealth Rocks on his side of the field, then he has to defog, which means he also removes the Stealth Rocks on my side of the field. So he decides to bring in his Exploud. I know Exploud has a lot of HP, so I don't think I can knock it out, and I do not want to lose my Starmie. So what I'm gonna do here is I am going to sack. Do I need my Muk actually? I need my Muk for his Gengar. And I don't think I need my Clefable. If I look at his team. Because Gengar wins against my Clefable. Garchomp is already really low. But I can also sack my Zapdos. Decisions, guys, decisions. Let's just sack Clefable here. Goes for Boom Burst. And yeah, that's definitely Choice Packs. Holy shit. That does so much damage. I'm just gonna protect here. Pretty much waste one more Boom Burst turn. And I'm just gonna sack this. Now I'm going into Garchomp. And I'll just go for Earthquake. Or should I just go for Earthquake here? As he stays in, he doesn't go into Zapdos. But that is nice. Because I kind of need my Garchomp. But yeah, he has room for one more attack. And now I can sack Zapdos. Goes for Dragon Claw. He will die to his own Life Orb. So Garchomp is gone as well. And now I'm free to outrage his team if I need to. He goes into Gengar. What I'm gonna do here is I'm gonna stay in. Because he might go for Trick or something. Let's go for Shadow Ball. And now he's trapped by my Muk. So I'm just gonna pursue there, because we don't see Life Orb, we don't see Black Sludge, so he's most likely Choice Scarfed or Choice Specs. I don't know, but I can see it from the damage. But yeah, he still lives. I'm just gonna go for pursuit again in case he is able to get off a defog with Zapdos. And now he disables my pursuit. That's still fine. Arcanine is coming in. And I'm just gonna sack my Muk here. So that I can bring in my Garchomp for free. Because he might have something like Will-O-Wisp. And I do not want to bring in my Garchomp on a Will-O-Wisp. Yeah, he goes for Flare Blitz anyway. And now we bring in our Garchomp. I could go into Starmie as well. But I'll just go Garchomp. I want to win the game with Garchomp. That's what we are going to do. And we're pressing Outrage here. Goes for Extreme Speed. He gets a crit, but that's fine. And now Zapdos takes Stealth Rocks damage. And we go for Outrage. I don't know if it goes for Roost, but it's fine. I can just let my Garchomp die. As he actually goes for Heat Wave, so he didn't Roost. And because of that, I'm going to switch into my Starmie now. Because if he knocks out my Starmie with a predicted Discharge or something, he didn't Roost, so then Garchomp just comes in and kills it. And if he Roosts now, I just knock it out with Ice Beam. As he actually goes for Heat Wave again. So we now knock him out with the Surf. And that's how we win the game. So a lot of kills in this game and a really fast game. Those are the kind of games that I love, guys. Just fast games.